There are now active cases of COVID-19 in 13 of Nunavut's 25 communities. Testing has been reduced to allow the healthcare system to still function. Schools remain closed, as do non-essential offices. Seven people are in hospital. Nunavut's premier had a conference call with the prime minister and other premiers yesterday. He repeated his plea for staffing help.
I noted that Nunavut continues to need help on the human resource front, especially nurses and lab technicians. I also stressed the need to address our housing gap. Overcrowding is severely impacting the spread of COVID-19 in our communities.
The government confirmed today that one of the reasons they need help is that five of the eight lab technicians who worked at the hospital in Iqaluit resigned in November and December. Nunavut's chief public health officer didn't know offhand how many lab technicians there are at the hospital right now.
I don't know the exact number, but we've only been able to, Kikiktani General Hospital has only been able to hire one since then.
While the ministers were in Iqaluit, Nunavummiut have Ottawa on their minds. The Embassy West Senior Living Complex in Ottawa has clients from Nunavut, and it's undergoing an outbreak of COVID-19 right now.
To date, we've had eight residents that have been infected with COVID. However, one of them is now considered recovered, so there's seven currently. We have been monitoring the situation closely. We've put in place an additional staff member on site to assist during this especially stressful period.
Nunavut now has 192 active cases of COVID, at least. Testing was scaled back last week, so that number is more of an educated guess than a statistic. For now, Nunavut remains on lockdown, and it seems it'll stay that way for some time to come. Kent Driscoll, APTN National News, Iqaluit.